Hello, absolutely nobody. It's Fat Rob here. Welcome back. Day or night, 115, 7 days to die in the PlayStation 4. So in the last episode, we were in the 00 city looking for a feral, and then all of a sudden, we came up with an idea that didn't expect that to happen. That what we'd do is we would try and create a crazy, crazy horde by putting down loads of forges and just messing around, basically. Originally the plan was that I was going to create a load of forge, come to the central part of this town, build up a massive tower or structure, and then light all the forges, and then, you know, we're away. But I've decided to do something slightly different because I have decided now that Horde Night 119, which is, you know, realistically only 4 nights away, is going to be my last Horde Night in this of season 2. Patch 1.12 has just come out. I don't think it's affected the game too much, but I did say when the next patch comes out we would start again. I am just about to go away as well for a week, so I won't be able to upload or anything. So what I'll do is I will film up until Horde Night 19, film Horde Night 19, then we'll end the series and we'll start a new series afterwards. Starting a new game. Brand new game, brand new map, online map, blah blah blah. But, so, with that in mind, what I thought I would do in this episode is start the structure. So the reason I knocked that down was because this is where I'm going to put the structure. So the idea is I'm going to go maybe 6 up. I might go at the same height as, say, one of these buildings here and build a bridge across or something like that. Anyway, so I'm going to go 6 up from here on a structure. And then I'm going to build a platform that can fit 21 forges on, along with a few few spaces for me to get to, because the idea is, I don't know if you walk on top of forges whether you get burned or not. I'm not sure. We'll find that out. Anyway, so the idea is what we'll do is we'll build a structure up here with 21 spaces. Excuse me a second. I thought I was going to die there. And then we'll come say midday on day 119, we'll light the forges, everything possible, we'll just light everything, and then we'll just let the hordes commence. But before that, we'll obviously do a little bit of kind of structural integrity. So, you know, these bars here, they've been getting bashed on for a while, so I'll probably refresh these bars, repair the base as much as I can, build as many bullets as I can, become as armed as I can. So anyway, that's the idea. And then we'll have one kind of epic ending. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start the thing. I might need to get some wood crates. So you know, do let me know in the comments if you think that's a good idea, a bad idea, if you're a bit upset that we're starting again, or happy. I'm feeling quite motivated by it. I'm just going to take that wood and make some wood frames. Because, you know, we've been where's wood frames? There's wood frames. How many do I need? Come on. I don't think I'm going to need that many, but just for the building's sake. Anyway, yeah, because I'm feeling quite good about it, because we, you know, we have had this map for quite a few months now. Can I put that down without it falling? That's just silly, isn't it? Can I get up it? I can't even get on top of it either. I'll pick that up. I might have to build across like this. That annoys me that you can't build on top of these things. Unless I just, of course, take one of these away. It's no big thing. Put that there. I've probably got 100 of them. So what we're going to do is... Yeah, so as I was saying, you know, we have... Is that going to be high enough? I think so, because I didn't really do that very well. I mean, that's going to be pillar number one. And pillar number two can be... say here. Take that one away. Doesn't necessarily have to be many do I need? 2, 3, 4. I think that's 4 high. Yeah, that's perfect. Then we can build out from here. As a kind of I suppose we don't even need to do that. We could just put a ladder up, and then what we'll do is we'll, I mean, how many spaces? I hate walking around with stuff in between me. 1, 2, 3. So three gaps, so we're looking at 1, 2, 2, 3, and then a pillar here. Yeah. Yeah, because, sorry, as I was saying, you know, we have done this map quite a lot. The map itself, I absolutely despise. I always have. 3, 4. And we've got another three spaces here, just because of the sheer amount of water. I wish there was a way somehow to check the map before you actually commit to the gameplay, because the amount of water really kind of spoils this map. 2, 3, 4. Okay. I might as well just put blocks in between here as well. I mean, it's not like I'm going to need them for protection or anything. But it's always good just to know you're consistent. Yeah. Sorry, I keep getting distracted. Yeah, because, as I was saying, the map itself has bugged me from day one, from the first week, because of the sheer amount of water that we've got. And it kind of does spoil it for me, because of, you know, the I thought I had concrete blocks. Mustn't have made them. Just because of the sheer amount of water. I know you guys are probably sick to death. Hello, crazy things. You're not getting in. Don't even try and get in. You're not getting in. It's crazy, though, how... Where did all these guys come from? It is crazy how sometimes just a general day in the life of being a apocalyptic survivor is worse than a Horde Knight. Look at them all falling down the gap. So here they all come. I mean, seriously, what are you guys all coming across for? I don't understand. There's nothing lit up. You know, you could come during the night. Come back on the 19th. Join the party on the 19th, that'd be better. Just walk in there. Why are you bugging me when I'm doing building? After me saying I'm not gonna do any more building missions. I might actually just go down with my sledgehammer, to be honest. I'll take this one out first. There goes your face. Oh! A little sneaky crawler there. Oi, oi, oi! Oh! Okay, I'm gonna die again, aren't I? I haven't even got a good weapon on me to properly... Well, I've got the sledgehammer, which is the best weapon, we all know. I haven't even got a gun on me, though. What is going on? Where are all these guys coming from? Come back during Horde Night, please. Maybe they've fixed spawning and not told us. It'd be interesting to see if I create a massively scary horde, and then all of a sudden they've fixed the Horde Night and I get absolutely destroyed. But that'd be a good ending to a really enjoyable playthrough. Oh, come on. I just want to get back to building. Go away. Stop jumping around. Oh, that's the guy who lost his arm right at the start. Belly shot for you. You can die. I tell you what, you're properly surviving. I should have just left you alive. It's a pet zombie. Are you going down? No. You didn't get me. No way. Oh, the crawlers are still alive as well. Oh. It's fun using the crossbow again, to be honest. Don't think he's dead. I just, no, the thought of starting again, it fills me with dread and also fills me with joy. Just you forget how annoying it is building that level one stone axe and having to hit a tree 100 times to get to knock a tree down. Oh god, yeah. I don't know if I can face that. At least I've got some time off between them. Are you kidding me? All right, let's get back to building. Unless there's more zombies out there. Right, all gone. Right, okay. So what I was saying. Yeah, the map itself. This map has always really, really annoyed me. And you close the door. And you can kind of see, because of the amount of water, it is kind of spoilt, because you've got to go miles around. But I suppose it adds a bit of... makes it a little bit different, doesn't it? Right, anyway. Yeah, so that's... I suppose that is the ultimate plan. We're going to create the ultimate horde, and then end the game after the ultimate horde, depending on how we get on. Not depending on how we get on. We're just going to end it. That's going to be it. Alright. Can I reach across there? Without falling? Just. Okay. That's cool. And I should be able to fill that in as well without... although I don't know... Oh, I don't know if that's going to be 21. That might be 21. 3333. Oh, well done. I'm doing well, aren't I? I mean, it's not a big deal. They don't necessarily have to be on this platform. It's just an idea that I had, so I'm gonna kind of fulfil it. Right, and I don't actually have to use. Why don't I do it easy? Why do I always do things a complicated way? So we'll keep building anyway. Yeah. So I mean, this is it. This is end game. It'll be good fun. So we have got, what, 4 days now. We've got 4 days to shore up, to gather the resources we need to have a massive end of days game. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Yeah, so we've got 25 spots up here. That's going to be absolutely loads. I might just jump down here. Don't really need these. They were just to make sure that we had space. And I might do I have my forges on me? Oh, I've got my forges on me. Well done, well done. You're doing well. I'm doing well. Okay. Alright, so pretty sure you can walk on top of forges, so I'm just going to put them all down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh, inside a forge. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Oh, I'm going to have to... Well, no, I suppose that's a good gap, because what I can do is, use that as a... I might build a ladder up here as well. That's probably what I'll do. And just because, you know, we're not going to need resources again. Well, maybe we are. Depending on how I feel, I'm not going to delete the game, I'll keep it. And as, like I said before, I'll bring you guys back in every now and then just to show you what I've been doing, if I've been doing anything. That'll do. They'll dry at some point. Right. Do I have any ladders? 1 ladder, 13 ladders. Okay, so let's just create a ladder up here. Not too fussed about making this pretty. Although I don't want that. There we go. And the ladders go here. So I can't put it down because that's stupid block. I mean, that's stupid. Anyway, at least we can jump up and climb up. And then here they all are. So we're going to light all that down there and all this down up here. So that's 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. So we need 25 100 pieces of wood. So I'm just going to ditch all that in here. Can't ditch that in there. And again, I know I've got specific places for these, but it's gotten to the point now where it doesn't really matter. So what we're going to do... Why did I... Oh. Yeah, you know what? I should probably be a bit more sensible about this, shouldn't I? Because I'm not I'm not deleting the game. I'm actually keeping it. So let's keep it as neat as possible. So put the... Still don't care, right? Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll head on. That just looks really cool. I probably should create just four more, but I don't have enough animal hide for bellows. Anyway, out the door. I'm going to be risky and leave it open because I don't care anymore. Well, I do care, but you know what I mean. And then we're going to head down to the wood farm. And again, I'm not going to replace it. Well, maybe I will. Depends how I feel. So we need 1,000 wood for each of those forges. We're just going to burn. I could have used coal, but again, I'm not going to delete the game. I'm going to come back to it, so no point in using a resource that may be handy to me later on. And at least if I use the wood, when I do come back to this game, I can easily replace it. We'll just head on down, chopping down these trees. And we are getting cones back from it as well, so we can, you know, we can replace it if I want. Glad the trees don't land on my head. Okay, I'll keep going. How many have we got there? So that's only 3,000. Oh my goodness. I think most of the tree farm's going to come. Or go. I mean, I might reduce the 1,000 to 500 per forge. I think that's probably going to give me well enough fuel to burn for a whole entire day anyway. So let's keep going. I'll do this row here and then we'll reevaluate what I've got. Here comes a zombie. At least it's daytime. I definitely heard a zombie there. Hey, hello nurse. It's creeping up from behind the tree. Just lie down. You're not needed right now. Come back later. Yeah, looks, sounds like there's another mini horde coming through as well. What does that? Yeah, I thought I could hear something else. Oh, no way did that miss. Oh, just stay still. Was that zombie really making all that noise? Just one zombie. Ridiculous how long that was. Right, so how many have we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, yeah, I think one more line of these will do. Then we can easily have 500 bits of wood per forge. And I think I've got some wood back there anyway, so we should have enough. And what I'll do is I'll quickly lay back down the tree farm as well, so that we're not short if I do come back into this game in my spare time or with you guys. Come on. 79 of them. Yeah, that's cool. It won't take me a second anyway, just to, you know, quickly. Or slowly. It's probably better me doing this in a slow rate, getting it bang on each time, than messing up. And we can go right around. I know I heard a zombie. But right now, a headless zombie. It doesn't really matter. I would also like to head into the town and pick up a little bit more brass, because I haven't got any back here, and you know we're really going to want to create as many bullets as possible. So brass is going to be something that's important. So once we've got the forges all set up and ready to just to ignite, I think what we'll do is we'll head probably not to Derelict City, because I've done that to death. Oh, maybe I have, maybe I haven't. Yeah, they've definitely broken the cactus, haven't they, in the last update. Okay, so yeah, that's going to be plenty of wood. Let's head back. And what we can do is we can, like I say, fill up the forges. Make sure everything's got a nice amount. And then head off to the nearest town to, well, maybe not the nearest town, but a town that's close for some brass hunting, which is generally just going to be radiators, car radiators, and the odd trash bin. And I think probably I'll limit myself just to picking up, left it open, limit myself just to picking up brass as well. Otherwise, I'll come back with a whole lot of junk I don't actually want. Right, so here we go. If I half that, yeah, 83 minutes is going to be absolutely loads. So I'll do them in rows. They look quite good from the top down. I don't know if that's what a forge actually looks like, and I'm pretty sure if it was like that, I wouldn't be able to stand on it. But oh no, don't do that. All right, not long. I'm glad I'm doing this now and not 10 minutes before Horde Night. This is going to take a little bit longer than I thought. And I'm not going to speed the video up, because I want you guys to suffer like I can, like I am. But you guys can fast forward, so that's not fair. Oh, come on. I wish you could quick click fuel into the forges. We know where it's going. Let me quick click. Can you? Let's have a look. No, you can't quick click. That's fine. I can go there. I can go there. Oh, have we just got enough? I can go there. I think we might have just picked up enough, you know. I can go right there. Alright, so that's all those forges filled out. And we've got three more, but I think I've got some wood in here. There's no point in lighting the ones down the bottom. Yeah, I mean, look at that there. That's perfect. So we've got three forges here. I mean, that's got some fuel in, so we'll just fill that up. I mean, how long is that going to go for? 65 minutes is going to be fine. 73 minutes is going to be fine. 55 minutes is going to be fine. We've got campfires. 200. I wonder as well if we should just lay up some campfires along the walls as well. Properly make, properly get a heat signature going. Yeah, why not? The campfires. I know I need to go and get, how many can I create? Do campfires stack? Oh, they do. Yes! This is going to be a proper heat source. Right, so I'm going to keep the front wall free, because I think that's, you know, that's the entrance, so that's where they're going to come in. But what I'll do is I'm going to need to go and get some more wood for this as well. I will lay down one every other one. I don't think there's much point in doing it every one, is there? Well, maybe there is. We'll do this then. This will make the base look really cool when it's all... Oh, there's a plane. The plane! Oh dear, okay. Well, that was always going to happen, wasn't it? I put too many down. And... my goodness. Campfire central. Right, as I say, I'm going to leave the front wall the same. you know what, just because of my the way my brain works, that's going to do my head in. So I'll put one there. And I'll take that one away. Take that one away. There you go. I will need fuel for these as well. And then continue on. We're still building campfires. Never had this many campfires in my life. I wonder how glitchy this is going to make the game. All this going on in the really small space. It's going to be fun though. Oh, is that right? Oh, these ones must be a bit longer. Okay, that's no worries. As long as we keep it kind of consistent. That one. That one. I'm gonna need to take down that whole entire tree farm, aren't I? Even if I put 250 wood in these campfires. I mean, this is going to create a massive heat signature as well. And we're nearly there. Don't fall asleep, guys. Cool. With 60 to go as well. Alright, that's fine. Drop down here. I'll put these away. Stick the campfires away. So I am going to need to go and get some more wood and brass. So it's probably back to the wood farm. Chop down some more of those trees. Imagine how this is going to look really cool lit up. Properly, fully lit up. All those lit up. All that lit up. So how many did I put down there? I can't remember. Gonna need a lot more trees. I'm gonna close it this time as well. Alright, back to the tree farm. Do some chopping. So yeah, I mean, let me know in the comments what you think. Is this a crazy idea? Am I gonna attract, you know, is there a threshold to the amount of zombies I can attract? Is it a bit futile? Am I only going to ever attract up to a certain amount of zombies? Do you know, is the heat signature, once you've created a certain amount of heat signature, it doesn't matter? I don't know. But it's always going to be fun to find out. I've got a nasty feeling that it's just going to completely glitch the game. These trees are big ones as well, so they're going to... going to get plenty of wood from this. Okay, keep going. As long as the zombies leave me alone as well, should be quite good. I mean, this is one thing I will miss when I start again, the fantastic tool set that we've got. But the good thing is, I think I'll play the game in the same... Oh, why do these have 1,000 now? Did they just grow? Oh well. Yeah, but the thing is, I think, you know, the way we play the game, we hunt for a forge house. That's the first thing we hunt for, and then from day one, if you're lucky enough to find one, you've got the ability to create iron tools. Weird. So, you know, from that perspective, we can build a tool set up relatively quickly, and there is ways to you know, exponentially increase the way your tool set levels up. It just gets to the point with me where, you know, if I'm above level 400 with my tool set, I'm not really that bothered, because you know, like this, 4 hits to take down 1,000 tree. If I was to hit that rock over there, it'd be 3 hits to take down that. So it doesn't really make kind of sense to me to create up to the 600. It's nice to have it, but you don't need it. As long as you've got a 600 sledge. Oh, the sledgehammer, I'll miss that as well. Oh well. And again, I'm just going to replant these just for the simplicity of, you know, if I do decide to come back to this game, it's going to be here, and it's going to be growing. And I don't necessarily have to worry too much. We've got plenty of food, we've got plenty of water, we've got plenty of resources, and I can pretty much pick the game up relatively easily. Okay. Come on. Yes. Of course. My house phone goes. Bear with me, guys. I'll be back. Sorry about that. I think you guys are probably quite used to my house phone ringing in the middle of videos. I think if it doesn't ring, you know something's wrong. Right, okay. Where did that crate come down? Did that crate just come down right at my doorstep? Nah, it's miles away. Plus, I'm not really that interested in any more beakers. Thank you very much, game. Right, so back to the base. Now, sorry, I had to move my mic. It wasn't in the right position. Yeah, so back to the base, and we will load up the. There's a zombie there. We'll load up the campfires with fuel. Shouldn't take too long. I'm not going to bring my Viking with me. Don't know why I've got them in my hand. Like an offering. Yep, so we'll load up the campfires and then probably make it to... Must be a quick way to do this. I mean, is that going to be... How many have I got there? So let's have a look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So I've got really enough of 32 if I do that. And how much does 250 take? Yeah, 41 minutes is plenty, isn't it? So we're going to be putting... It might take a little bit more time this way. But we're going to be putting in 250. Oh, see, that's going to irritate me. See, this is. Right. Oh, goodness. I'm gonna speed this bit of the video up, guys, so you don't have to watch me. I will. I like you guys too much to punish you. I'll speed you guys in a minute. Okay, welcome back. I'm nearly there. Can you imagine if I'd done every single square? Oh, I think repetitive strain syndrome on my thumbs doing this. You think you'd get quicker, but you just get more sloppy and forgetful. So I'm nearly done anyway. And then what we'll do is we will jump on our bike and then I'll head towards the nearest town, but I'll probably call... Am I going to run out of wood? I'll probably call it an end to the episode, to be honest. And then in the next episode, we can be creating, raiding cities for resources we're going to need for this epic horde night, hopefully. Because I am running short on bullets. Shut up, zombie. Just killed one of you. Ah, brothers. I'm deliberately not equipping any weapons because I don't want to use any bullets. They're all just wandering across like stupid zombies. Is any of you getting back up? Yeah, you're getting back up. Go away. Seriously, just go. Stop bringing zombies in. I don't want them right now. Is that another one? Oh my goodness. Look at this. Oh, you know what? I'm going down. In fact, I'm going to leave them. I'm just going to leave them. They're not going to do any damage to my base. And also, I want to get this finished. I've only got like 4 to do. So it's not going to be that bad. I mean, look at that though. How lucky is that? And I've got 500 wood to spare. Let's go down and say hello to these guys. Hello. Yes, you're dead. And you're dead. You're dead. You're dead. Another zombie, so they're already dead. You know what I mean? It's ridiculous. Mini hordes. I do. The thing is, I really, really like the mini horde idea. I like the fact that, you know, if you any of you guys watch The Walking Dead, there's a potential for a massive walking horde just to appear at any point and get you. I like that idea a lot. And I suppose that's what we've got here. You know, we've got a decent sized horde coming to try and do me in. But what they don't realise is that I am the sledgehammer master. And if they come this spread apart and they don't bunch up, they are no match. I need to name my sledgehammer really, don't I? I'll do that in the next playthrough. See, the moment you get hit, they do overrun you. And then the moment your stamina starts, decreasing, you stop the one shot hit. Oh, who's getting me now? Crawlers. Are you still alive? You dirty scum. My goodness. The fact that you don't have one shot hit with a sledgehammer doesn't even stun them after a while. They're both dead. He's thinking about being alive again, so I'm going to do his head. You can stay down. Anyway, okay, so I'm going to call that a day. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you've stuck with me. I wonder what was going on there. They were all moving. So yeah, you can see what we're doing. And I think what we're doing is going to cause a lot. You sneaky woman. What are you doing in here? All quiet and just waiting for me to walk in and jump me. Wasn't keen on that. Anyway, yeah, so you can kind of see the idea. This is going to be one big heat signature. And if we light that, say, lunchtime-ish on day 119, we'll get mini horde after mini horde, and then we'll get the proper horde as well. So it's going to be epic. It's going to be epic. I'm going to tell myself that with the hope it is. Anyway, so I'm going to leave it there. So as always, thank you very much for watching. If it's your first time here, hello, welcome. You know, if you like what you've seen, please subscribe. I do generally release a 7 days to die video every day. I've also got a nice back catalogue of nearly two full series of me playing this game, so you know, and some random videos and tutorials that you can watch as well if you're interested, and a few other games that I play. So you know, please check them out as well. Also, if you feel like commenting, please do. I try and respond to as many as possible, and we've got a nice little community of people speaking to each other at the moment. So you know, hopefully that will continue as well. But anyway, I'm going to call this one to an end, and I will speak to you all in the next episode. Okay, take care. Bye now.